Pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi dimanapun kalian berada, kembali lagi kita dalam program Bimbingan Belajar untuk siswa-siswi kelas 11. Hari ini mata pelajaran kita Bahasa Inggris, dan selama 1 jam kita akan bersama dalam berbagi ilmu untuk semua. Di studio nanti kita akan kedatangan narasumber kita, namun sebelumnya kita akan mendengarkan dulu alunan nada pembuka. Kita dengarkan bersama-sama.
Seindah mentari, hangatkan dinginnya resah hatimu. Ku sadar ku tak seindah melodi, mengiringi jejak langkahmu. Ku sadar ku tak rasa cinta, ku akui padamu tak berdaya, hatiku menyerah. Selamat tinggal duka, sambut bahagia untuk selamanya. Dengar rasa yang ku, kaulah pelabuhan terakhirku. Takkan bisa ku jalani waktu tanpa diri. Yeah.
Baik pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi, kita kembali lagi dalam program bimbingan belajar untuk siswa-siswi kelas 11. Bersama saya telah hadir Miss Halimatuk Syadiah MPD. Beliau adalah guru bahasa Inggris di SMK Negeri 2 Bandar Lampung. Dan Miss Rebecca yang merupakan English Teaching Assistant MNF. Dan saat ini materi kita tentang conditional sentences. Baik, apa kabar Miss? Baik,
kabar
semuanya?
Baik.
Alhamdulillah,
we are doing
semua.
Well today.
Iya. Jadi kita semangat ya tetap untuk memberikan penjelasan tentang materi kita. Baik Miss, kita mulai saja ya. Mm-hmm. Oke, silakan Miss.
Oke. How are you, Miss Halima?
Okay, I'm okay.
Me too. Okay. I'm healthy today. So, today our subject matter is conditional sentences. A conditional sentence explains probable events. If I explain conditional sentences well, you will understand how to use conditional sentences in English today. Today, we will talk about one form of conditional sentence in our first section. This is conditional sentence type 1. A good example is, if we talk to you today, you will practice listening to English. Conditional sentence type 1 has two parts. The first is the if clause, if you listen to us, and the second is the main clause, you will practice English listening. So I will repeat that. Number one, the if clause, if you listen to our lesson, and the main clause, you will practice English listening. I will explain more later. So we are only talking about conditional sentences that use the present and future tense in this section. The first type is talking about facts, scientific facts, and habitual events. In these examples, we will only use simple present tense. Example one, we usually go to the beach if we have a vacation. Miss Halima,
okay.
If you have a vacation, where do you usually go?
I will go to the nice place.
Ooh, yeah.
Like a beach or mall. Okay, if I have holiday, I will go to a beach or mall.
Yeah, Miss Halima likes luxury. If she has a vacation, she goes to the resort or the mall.
Okay.
I like camping and adventure. So
yeah.
If I have a vacation. My dream vacation. If I have a vacation, I go to the mountain.
Oh.
Or I go to the beach. Okay. I also like the beach.
Yeah, if Miss Rebecca, if she has holiday, she will go to mountain, to the beach, mm-hmm. and then to Pulau Pisang. She will go to Pulau Pisang.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, if I have a long vacation.
Okay.
You can also... So you can say, if I have a vacation, I go to the beach.
Okay.
You can also reverse the sentence. So the main clause is first, and then the if clause is second. So you can say, I go to the beach if I have a vacation. Or I usually go to the beach if I have a vacation. Another example, if it is not raining, we always have football practice. or we always have football practice if it isn't raining. All of those examples are about repeated events or habitual events. We use simple present tense for situations like this. Another way to use conditional sentences type 1 is to talk about expected future events. Okay, so in the future of conditional type 1, I will give you some examples. The grammar structure is the if clause uses simple present tense and the main clause uses future tense. Do you remember future tense? Future
yes.
tense.
I will.
Yeah,
okay.
I will. He will.
He will.
She will.
She will.
Okay, so the if clause is about what must happen before the main clause can be true. So the main clause will be true in the future if the if clause is true. So, example one, if you study hard, you will get good grades. So, you will get good grades only if you study hard. The result of studying hard is getting good grades. Another example, if you sleep in class, your teacher will be angry. In this one, the result of sleeping in class is making your teacher angry. Ms. Halima,
okay.
What do you do if your student sleeps in class?
Okay, I will pour the water into the student's face.
That's right. If you sleep in Ms. Halima's mm-hmm. class, she will pour water on your head.
Yeah.
So be careful
yeah.
if you sleep. You will get a punishment.
Okay.
Another example. If it rains, we will not go to football practice. Or we will not go to football practice if it rains. The result of rain is not going to football mm-hmm. practice. In these examples, we used what tenses? Do you remember?
They are using present tense, right?
Mm-hmm. Present tense.
And then future tense too.
Yeah.
Will. And then, we can use to be going to too, right?
Yeah.
Is it?
You
Is
can
it?
Also okay. use to be going to.
To be going to.
Like, if you study hard,
mm-hmm.
you are going to get good grades.
Mm-mm.
So, you remember simple future tense because Ms. Halima gave you a review. And if you want a negative sentence, like if it rains, we will not go to football practice.
Yes.
You just add not. You can say will not or won't.
Okay.
So if it rains, we will not go to football practice, or if it rains, we won't go to football practice.
But sometimes students will go if there is rain. In our students.
Wow. Our students are
yeah.
very dedicated.
Yeah. They really like football game.
Wow. So now we will have a short dialogue about your two teachers, about me, Miss Rebecca, and Miss Halima.
Okay.
And our vacation plans. Please listen carefully for the conditional sentences.
Okay. Hello, Miss Celine. How are you today?
I'm okay. How are you, Miss Halima?
Oh, I'm great. I'm excited for my vacation.
Where will you go?
If the weather is good, I will go to the beach with my family.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That sounds fun. If I have free time, I usually just relax at home.
Oh, I always travel if I have free time.
If I get bored at home, maybe I will travel with a friend.
Ah, but remember to be safe in if you travel. Okay.
Okay, did you hear the conditional sentences?
Yeah. I hear.
Okay, I hear.
So, I will go to the beach. Yeah, we will go to the beach. Mm-hmm. Okay.
When?
If it is not rain.
If it is not raining, okay. You will go to the beach.
Okay. Can we use... okay, how about Miss Rebecca? What will you do if you go to Bali? Have you?
I have never gone to Bali. But if I go to Bali, I will see Ubud Temple.
Ubud Temple, okay.
And I will go to the beach.
What will you do in Ubud Temple?
If I go to Ubud Temple, I will look at the beautiful architecture and history.
History. But, okay, now if you... to Bali. How about if you... Have you ever been to Sumatera Barat?
I have been to Sumatera Barat.
Sumatera Utara?
Not yet.
What will you do if you go to Sumatera Utara?
If I go to Sumatera Utara, I will go to Danau Toba.
Oh, Danau Toba. So what will you do in Danau Toba?
If I go to Danau Toba, I will look at the beautiful view.
Okay. Okay, if you... how about if you have free time in the New Year's? What will you do? New Year Eve, what will you do?
If I have free time on New Year's Eve, I will spend time with my family.
Oh, you will spend time with your family.
Yeah.
What will you do then?
We will listen to music.
And
maybe we will dance. And we will wait for midnight. Maybe we will watch TV.
Okay, what's TV?
Yeah, watch the in America there is a big ball in New York City that drops at midnight.
Okay. Maybe I will celebrate New Year with your family too in
the US. If you come to the US, what will you do?
I will visit Washington, D.C.
Okay.
And I will go to Hollywood.
Very far from Washington, D.C.
I will go to the Washington, D.C. and I will go to Hollywood. I will meet artists.
Oh, yes.
Good idea.
I will come with you.
Okay, we'll go together.
I want to meet all of the famous people, too.
Okay.
All right. We will return with conditional type 2.
Okay.
Thank you for listening.
Baik, pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi, bagaimana tadi Miss Rebecca dan juga Miss Halimah tadi sudah mulai berconversation dan mudah-mudahan kalian dapat menangkap apa maksud yang tadi sedang diobrolkan Miss Halimah dan Miss Rebecca. Baik, setelah yang berikut nanti kita akan kembali lagi. Tetaplah di sini di Bimbingan Belajar untuk siswa-siswi kelas 11.
Katakan padaku bahwa semua ini harus kita akhiri. sadar kau masih mencintaiku dan aku tak ingin pisah.
Sedang mendengarkan acara Bimbel, Bimbingan Belajar di Radio Gema Edukasi, berbagi ilmu untuk semua.
Pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi, kita kembali lagi masih dalam program Bimbingan Belajar untuk siswa-siswi kelas 11. Di studio masih bersama kita ada Miss Halimah dan juga Miss Rebecca yang nanti akan terus menjelaskan tentang conditional sentences. Baik Miss, silahkan dilanjutkan kembali.
Okay, kita kembali lagi pendengar Gema Edukasi. Kita akan bicarakan tentang conditional sentence type 2. Miss Rebecca dan Miss dan saya tadi sudah membahas tentang conditional type 1. Sekarang kita akan bahas lagi tentang conditional sentence type 2. Karena sebenarnya conditional sentence ini ada 3, conditional type 1, conditional type 2 dan conditional type 3. Yang akan kita bahas adalah conditional type 2. Conditional type 2 biasa disebut present unreal, adalah untuk mengandaikan kondisi yang tidak mungkin terjadi pada saat kita berbicara atau kondisinya berlawanan dengan apa yang ada saat ini. Kadang-kadang kan kita tuh, oh seandainya kemarin, menyesali apa yang sudah terjadi. Seandainya tadi malam, seandainya baru saja. Nah, itu yang kita menggunakan conditional type 2. Adapun conditional type 2 itu menggunakan subject would, kemudian verb 1 atau be complement atau verbing, kemudian if, setelah itu menggunakan past tense. Tapi di sini kita untuk to be-nya kita hanya menggunakan were. Contohnya yang menggunakan kata kerja dulu. If she didn't meet me, she would decide to suicide. Jadi ada kejadian nih. Ada orang yang membunuh diri kemarin. Jadi tidak jadi karena dia bertemu. She didn't meet me. She would decide. If she didn't meet me, she would decide to suicide. Jadi kenyataannya dia bertemu, she meet me, so she doesn't suicide. Jadi dia tidak jadi bunuh dirinya gitu ya. I would, kemudian ini contoh yang kedua. I would be there now if she invited me to her wedding party. Jadi ada pernikahan kemarin, sayangnya saya tidak diundang. Sebenarnya saya pengen ke sana. I would be there now if she invited me to her wedding. Tapi kenyataannya saya tidak diundang. Kemudian ini lagi ada kalimat, I would study abroad if I pass the final test. Kenyataannya I don't pass the final exam. Oke, kemudian ini ada lagi, ada yang bercita-cita. If that man had much money, that man would marry the girl. Tapi kenyataannya that man doesn't have much money, jadi tidak jadi pernikahannya ya. So he doesn't marry that girl. Oke, kemudian kalimat berikutnya. I would tell you the truth if I knew it. Kenyataannya I don't know the truth. Jadi kenyataannya dalam bentuk present. Sedangkan pengandainya menggunakan would dan type 2. Kemudian seperti yang bicarakan itu, yang kita bicarakan adalah kalimat conditional sentence yang menggunakan kata kerja. Sedangkan yang tidak menggunakan kata kerja, kita menggunakan to be. To be-nya yaitu were. Right, Rebecca? Not was.
Always were.
Always were. If I were you, I would go away. Kenyataannya I'm not you. Jadi tidak menggunakan I was you, but I were you, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I were you. She would never love him if he weren't kindly hearted person. Kenyataannya dia she love him because he is kindly hearted person, mm-hmm. right? Okay. Jadi karena dia baik, makanya dinikahi ya. Oh, is it make it mad? I don't think so. So using he weren't, seharusnya kan menggunakan was, right? Tapi karena pengandaian they are using weren't.
Mm-hmm. It's an exception, to the rule.
But for the conversation too, it's okay.
I think sometimes native English speakers forget this mm-hmm. rule.
Oh, forget it. But it's something that...
But it's correct it to correct. Say it weren't, just, not wasn't.
Oh, not wasn't, yeah. not weren't. Okay. Were she here? Were she here, I would tell her that I love her. Mm. There is no if here. Were she here, I would tell her that I love her. Is it correct? Is it okay?
I think that is correct, but it is... not common.
Oh, it is like question, were she here, right?
Yeah, people I think would usually say if she were here, I would tell her I love her.
But it's okay to not to use if. Tidak apa-apa, yeah. tidak menggunakan if-nya.
Maybe that's more normal in British English.
Oh, in the British English, were she here. Jadi if-nya dihilangkan ya. Soalnya if she were here, tapi bisa dibalik, were she here, mm-hmm. I would tell her that I love her. Kenyataannya she isn't here, so I don't tell her. Ini contoh yang lain lagi. Were you at home now, she would visit us. Sama ya, if-nya hilang. Seharusnya if you were at my home, she would visit us. You are not at my home, so she doesn't visit mm-hmm. us. Okay. That is conditional type 2. Itu conditional type 2. Okay. Kita lihat lagi. Conditional type 2... functionnya seperti yang dikatakan tadi, untuk menyatakan kenyataan yang tidak terjadi sekarang. If I were taller, I would buy that dress, for example, because that dress look for slim people,
for tall people.
So I'm not tall. So
maybe I can wear it.
Yeah.
If I were short, okay, I would wear that dress.
Okay. So okay. Jadi if I were taller, I would buy that dress. Jadi tidak, I'm not tall, so I don't buy the dress. Rebecca will buy the dress, yeah, because it's for. Jadi menggunakan I were. Seperti ini lagi, if he was 20, he would travel to the world. Seharusnya dia menggunakan was, tapi karena conditional if, dia menggunakan he were 20. He would travel. Kenyataannya he is not 20 and he doesn't travel the world. Okay. Present conditional if ini memang seperti kita berhayal tentang sesuatu. Kalau yang tadi future tense itu pasti masih mungkin terjadi, I will, tapi kalau yang type 2 itu memang tidak mungkin terjadi lagi. Jadi sudah tidak mungkin terjadi, tinggal angan-angan. Okay, now here.
What about questions?
About like, question.
If you were a superhero, what would you do?
With superhero.
Any superhero. What would you do?
If I were a superhero, I would choose to be where the sup. No, not flying. Maybe blink, ting ting. I would help. I would travel to the world and I would help some people.
Oh, okay. So if you make a question in type 2 conditional, you can say, if you were blah blah blah,
what would you do? Jadi bisa disebutkan dulu. If you had a lot of money, what would you do?
Yeah, if I had a lot of money, I would give it to all of my friends and family, and I would also keep some for myself. Okay,
maybe you would travel again to run part of the world. Okay, yeah. If I had a lot of money too, I would go to I would go to the New Zealand.
Ooh, it's beautiful there.
It's beautiful. Okay, I would go to New Zealand. How about you? If you had a lot of money, which country would you visit?
I think if I had a lot of money, I would visit. I would visit India and Papua.
Oh, but you are not allowed to go to Papua. Dangerous.
After my program is over. Oh,
but visa will approve it. No.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. If your government approve your visa, so you will go to Papua.
If I had a lot of money.
Oh, if you have a lot of money. So what will you do there?
Raja Ampat.
Oh, you will go to Raja Ampat. Yeah, they say that it's very beautiful. Okay. So, itu tadi conditional type 2. Okay. Okay, how about if you do you know that superhero, what would you do? I haven't asked you about
that. If I were a superhero, I would have invisibility powers.
Oh yeah,
I have the power to be invisible.
Yeah, I like the invisible one, that flying
so
one.
So I can go anywhere and no one will see me.
Okay, if we fly, everyone can see, right? So yeah, we would be famous. So okay, now again, if you won lottery, what would you do?
Let's give the students some time to think about it.
Okay.
If you won the lottery,
yes,
what would you do?
Yeah. Okay. pendengar Gema Edukasi, if you won lottery for maybe for 100 million rupiah, mm-hmm. okay, what would you do? Kalau menang 100 juta rupiah, what would you do? Okay, kalau Miss Rebecca will go to Raja Ampat, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll go to India.
Yeah.
To meet Shah Rukh Khan.
Maybe.
Do you know Shah Rukh Khan?
Yeah.
Oh, it's famous, yeah, Shah Rukh Khan. Okay. So what would you do if you won a lottery for 100 million rupiah? Pendengar Gema Edukasi. Oh, maybe Miss Rebecca will answer the question.
Okay. If I won the lottery for 100 million rupiah,
mm-hmm.
I would go to Raja Ampat and India.
Yeah, you have answered that question, yeah? Okay, if you had an island.
Ooh, if I had an island.
Yeah. Okay, if you had a chance to have an island, in which country would you have it?
That's easy.
Well,
if I had an island, I would have an island in Indonesia.
Okay, where is it?
Maybe Lampung Barat.
Lampung Barat.
I would own Pulau Pisang.
Okay. Yeah, kalau punya kesempatan punya apa namanya pulau, Miss Rebecca would have Pulau Pisang. Okay, yeah. Yeah, okay. If I had an island, I would have it in I don't know, somewhere in Indonesia too, maybe.
In Indonesia.
But should be safe island.
Well, you can have a safe boat to get to Pulau Pisang.
To get to Pulau Pisang. Okay, but it's very long, yeah. Okay. A long journey. Okay. Okay, now I have do you have any story about conditional if type 2? Miss Rebecca, where is it? Okay.
Yeah, I can tell a story.
Okay, you can have a story.
So, this story is, if I were famous.
Mm-mm.
If I were famous, I would own Pulau Pisang.
Okay.
And I would have a big boat that was very safe so that Miss Halima can come to Pulau Pisang safely to visit me.
Okay.
Also, if I were famous, I would be an actress on Sinetron.
Oh.
How about you, if you were famous?
If I were famous, I would make my popularity to do useful thing. For example,
not like me.
I would have my institution, educational institution. So I would promote it by using my name. I promote by using my name. Like artist. Or I would be pejabat, the mayor of the city or the governor. So people would choose me. Okay. But that is maybe I would have the institution and then I make it. I would promote it by using my name like other. Maybe I would have my own brand, Susu's. All right, Susu's scarf and then bag, okay, perfume.
And then maybe some of the money will be donated to a good organization to help people.
Yeah, so we can but sometime when we were famous, we would forget about all those things.
Yeah, maybe.
Well,
that's why we're using type 2. It's
type
because
2.
It's not likely.
Yeah, it's not likely. So that's why we are not famous.
Yeah, just in our imagination.
Just in our imagination.
So if you listeners want to use your imagination,
yes,
think about what you would do if you were famous.
Mm-mm.
and use the type 2 conditional.
Yeah. So something which cannot be happen right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, for using conditional type 2. Okay, I think that's it about conditional type 1 and type 2. We will back again. Kita akan kembali lagi setelah yang berikut ini.
Baik, pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi, semakin menarik dan semakin ramai pembicaraan kita tentang conditional sentences. Jadi, nanti kita akan kembali lagi. Tetap di sini ya. Dan setelah yang berikut, kita akan kembali lagi.
Saat malam, langit tanpa bintang coba menggoyahkanku, merapuhkanku di sini. Ku coba tegar kini tanpa dirimu kasih yang selalu menemani. Cintaku kau abaikan, kau beri air mata.
Anda masih bersama Radio Gema Edukasi, membagi ilmu untuk semua.
Insan Edukasi, terima kasih kalian tetap setia bersama kami dalam mengikuti program bimbingan belajar untuk kelas 11 dan materi kita tentang conditional sentences. Namun tak terasa waktu kita habis, Miss Halimah, untuk memberikan kesimpulan. Silakan, Miss.
Okay, selamat sore. Kita bertemu lagi untuk membahas tentang kesimpulan yang sudah kita pelajari hari ini, yaitu conditional type 1 dan conditional type 2. Jadi, conditional sentence ini ada 3, yaitu conditional type 1, conditional type 2, dan conditional type 3. Tapi yang kita bahas hari ini adalah conditional type 1 dan conditional type 2. Conditional type 1 merupakan untuk menyatakan kejadian yang akan terjadi, yang kita bayangkan akan terjadi. Jadi, kita menggunakan future tense, I will. Contohnya, I will buy the book if I have the money. Mungkin besok kalau saya sudah punya uangnya, saya akan beli buku itu. I will buy the book if I have the money. Kemudian, this afternoon, if it is not raining, I will go to gymnastic place to do the exercise. Okay. Atau boleh juga if you study hard, you will get good grade. Dalam kenyataannya itu pasti masih bisa terjadi kalau kita belajar dengan keras dan juga dengan baik. Contoh yang lainnya, if you sleep in class, your teacher will be angry. Itu pasti terjadi. Kalau tidur dalam kelas, gurunya pasti marah. Nah, itu masih bisa terjadi. Kemudian, sore ini juga nih, kalau if it rains, rencananya kan mau main bola. Ternyata kalau dia rains, we will not go to football practice. Jadi, kalau hari ini hujan, tidak akan bermain sepak bola. Jadi masih bisa terjadi. Tapi kalau conditional type 2 itu kenyataannya yang terjadi sekarang. Kita berhayal, if I were superhero, I would help lot of people. Kenyataannya kita bukan super, we are not superhero. Kita hanya manusia biasa. Jadi we don't help other people. Kemudian if I had an island, kalau saya punya sebuah pulau, I would take my friends to the island. Saya akan membawa teman-teman saya ke pulau itu. Kenyataannya, I don't have that island, so I don't take my friends to the island. Jadi kalau kita menggunakan conditional type 2, would, verb 1, kemudian if, subject, verb 2. Sedang itu yang menggunakan kata kerja. Kalau tidak menggunakan kata kerja, dia menggunakan were. If I were a doctor, if I were famous people, if I were superhero, kenyataannya I am not famous people, I am not a doctor. Jadi yang type 2, conditional type 2 itu merupakan sebuah hayalan. Itu saja kesimpulannya yang bisa kami berikan hari ini. Mudah-mudahan bermanfaat dan bisa dimengerti. Terima kasih.
Baik, terima kasih Miss Halimah dan juga Miss Rebecca telah meluangkan waktu untuk bersama-sama kita mempelajari bahasa Inggris, dan di lain kesempatan nanti kita akan bertemu lagi. Demikianlah pendengar Radio Gema Edukasi dimanapun kalian berada, usailah sudah kebersamaan kita dalam mata pelajaran bahasa Inggris dengan materi conditional sentences bersama saya Miss Halimah Tusyadiah MPD. Beliau adalah guru bahasa Inggris di SMK Negeri 2, dan juga Miss Rebecca yang merupakan English Teacher Assistant di MINF. Baik, dengan demikian saya Rahma pamit undur diri dari ruang dengar kalian, dari Studio Dinas Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan Provinsi Lampung, Radio Gema Edukasi, berbagi ilmu untuk semua. Pamit, sampai jumpa dan tetap semangat.